Good day, everyone. Welcome to Teacher Julie Channel. Hello, everyone. We have our new lesson in Science 7, which is all about the states of matter and particle arrangement through diagrams. This will be the first quarter topic and learning competency number 4. This topic is under the Matatag curriculum. Prior knowledge, all you have to do is to begin the lesson by projecting a diagram or image that illustrates the kinetic molecular theory. Ask the students to take a moment to observe the image and think about what it represents. Facilitate a brief discussion, prompting students with questions such as, what do you notice about the arrangement and movement of the particles in this diagram? And what prior knowledge about solid, liquid, and gases does this diagram help you remind you of? Then, record the students' responses and connections to the KMT image on the board or in the class discussion. In establishing the purpose, you explain to the students that today they will be learning about the three main states of matter and how the arrangement of particles differ in each state. In unlocking content vocabulary, we are going to use the match type activity. So here, the students will match the key vocabulary terms to their corresponding definitions, reinforcing their understanding of the concepts. So you are going to invite the students to come up one at a time and match a definition card to the appropriate vocabulary term. As each students make a match, have them explain why they think the definition matches the term. In the developing and deepening understanding, begin by asking students to how do you imagine the arrangement of particles in a solid, liquid, or gas? And what tools or visuals help you understand the concept better? So you are going to use a diagrams or animations to illustrate the particle arrangement in solid, liquid, and gases. In solids, these are the particles that tightly pack in a fixed orderly arrangement due to strong intermolecular forces. In liquids, particles are close together but can flow and move past each other due to moderate intermolecular forces. And gases, particles are spread out and move freely in all directions due to the weak intermolecular forces. For the work example, you are going to conduct hands-on demonstration to reinforce the concept. In solid, show ice cubes and have students observe the rigid and fixed structure. In liquid, show a container of water and have students observe the fluid, shapeless nature. While in gas, boil water and have students observe the steam, noting how it expands to fill. Changes in the states of matter in terms of temperature changes. Increasing temperature give particles more kinetic energy. This allows particles to overcome the intermolecular forces. Particles can then transition to a higher energy state, for example, solid to liquid, liquid to gas. Decreasing temperature has the opposite effect, allowing intermolecular forces to dominate. In terms of pressure changes, increasing pressure pushes particles closer together. This strengthens the intermolecular forces, and it can cause transition to lower energy state from gas to liquid and liquid to solid. Decreasing pressure allows particles to spread out, weakening the intermolecular forces. In making generalization, you are going to ask the students, what are the key differences in particle arrangement between solids, liquids, and gases? Another question is asked to the students, what general patterns or relationships did you observe in the particle arrangement? For the last question, ask the students, can you think of any real-world example that illustrates this particle arrangement concept?